Good morning and welcome to this, the first anniversary edition of Council Matters. Is it a year ago, Colin? What do you reckon? Does it seem? Doesn't time fly when you're not...
It does. Wow. We've covered a lot and more to come.
We certainly have, and rattled a few cages and even delighted a few listeners. Yes, you're listening to Council Matters, as we say, the most watched radio programme in Dublin. But very sadly, I have to start off today's programme with an announcement. I only discovered this last evening. Una Uí Lachtnain, who would be better known to most people as Una Loftus. She was the wife of the late... Séan Loftus, who was the former Lord Mayor of Dublin. She was also the former Lady Mayoress of Dublin. Very sadly, she passed away yesterday after a sudden illness. Una always went under her own name, Uí Lachtnain, because she was an individual in her own right. She made amazing contributions in the Dublin Development Board, and she was also involved in Pobal Cluain Tarbh. Una was a friend of mine. She was also a neighbour, and she was very, very sadly missed. So... for anybody who is intending to go and pay their respects to Una, the removal will be at 6 p.m. From Wednesday. You can visit her home from 6 p.m. this evening. The removal will be at St. Gabriel's in Dollymount from 6 p.m. tomorrow. And then the service will be at 10 o'clock on Friday. They're not asking for flowers. They're saying give a donation to the Irish Cancer Society. That sums up Una to a T. Slána chora, thosu lechon a chéile rasharish. So Una Loftus, Una Uí Lachtnain. She will be very sadly missed. But today, as I say, it is the first anniversary. And what are we going to look at today? Later on in the programme, Colin's going to be talking to the very lovely Kim O'Donnell, and she will be... standing for the People Before Profit Alliance up there in Rathmines in the council elections coming up. But first of all, local government has been in the news this week, particularly out there in Fingal. Now, Fingal didn't exist when I was a kid. I wonder, will it exist when other people are? Because at the rate they're going, Fingal are almost like that ostrich with their head in the sand. They're not going to let the people have a vote on whether we should have a directly elected Lord Mayor, because 16 of them didn't like it. Now, I had a look at this and I thought they had some very, very interesting comments on this. I mean, one of the... I won't mention the councillors involved, but one of them actually went as far as to say you'd never get a pothole fixed in North County Dublin anymore if there was a directly elected Lord Mayor. And another one said people are more interested in a taxi rank in Malahide. Well, they must have a lot to do out in Malahide if that's the case. And then a third one from the Socialist Party, and this was my personal favourite, and I'll come back to it. He said they didn't want power being concentrated in a single source. So I had a look at how do they handle local democracy in Fingal. And the one thing I had a look at is my specialist subject, which is twinning. Now, there was a proposal as far back as 2003 to have a look at twinning with a European local government, and eventually got round to it apparently in about 2010, and the local government they decided to twin with was, that's right, Chengdu. Where is that? It's in China. Now, I can imagine there's a lot in common with Chengdu in China, because they've got a population of 15 million and Fingal has a population of 250,000. And they were even saying some of the benefits could be tourism. Can you imagine all those millions and millions of Chinese saying, we're going to rush for our holidays, or we're going to Skerries? I think it could be terrific. So that's what they decided to do. And I wonder how the Socialist Party would say, yes, concentration of power, we don't support that, but Chengdu's okay. So that's local government in Fingal this week. But the other issue as well that's coming up, of course, as well, is this is Dublin City Council, the Battle of Clontarf commemoration. And this is what I'm calling when mythology meets history, because I think it's generally accepted, particularly in Clontarf, that the Battle of Clontarf didn't actually take place in Clontarf. It took place in Drumcondra. But that's not really sexy enough, is it? The Battle of Drumcondra, it sounds like a skirmish up at the Fianna Fáil branch up there, doesn't it? But anyway, what we're going to have, and this is what I suppose is the issue I wanted to raise with Dublin City Council, was the Battle of Clontarf. We're going to have a series of commemorative talks, lunchtime talks. Very good. Terrific. They're going to be about, where have I got the... subjects as the Field of Glory, Historical Antiquarian Perspectives on the Battle of Clontarf. Queen Gormla. Did you know who Queen Gormla was, Colin?
No.
She was Brian's mum.
Okay.
Strangely, she was also Viking. But that's a separate matter.
It was Ireland versus the Danes, in a sense.
Ireland versus the Norsemen.
Or the Norsemen,
yes. The Norsemen, yeah. Anyway, these are all going to be taking place in Dublin City Hall, is starting on the 1st of April, well, yesterday. So if you missed out on that Field of Glory, there'll be Queen Gormla next week. However, the point I raise is that if this is about the Battle of Clontarf, and we are trying to focus on certain historical issues, why are none of these talks actually not taking place in Clontarf? They're all taking place in the City Hall. Now, this was the point Fingal made, is that we would be getting Dublin-centric policies. I'm afraid, despite my criticism of them, they may be right. So, should you want to go and see Commemorating the Clancy Chain and the Celtic Revival, that'll be on the 22nd. The Brian Boru Harp and its Musical Legacy, what to do with Clontarf, that one, 29th of April, or even Picturing the Battle of Clontarf, James Ward's Murals in Dublin City Hall. Not a lot to do with Clontarf, but a lot to do with, as I say, academe and those sorts of things. So, well done to Dublin City Council for producing an entire series of lectures about a battle that may or may not have taken place in Clontarf and that may have made a difference. However, I will finish on a note, an economic note, and that is, I had a look at the benchmarks, and if we take employment, if we take economic growth, if we take financial stability, women's rights, gay rights, energy rights, we probably would have been better off losing the Battle of Clontarf and speaking either Norwegian and Danish, because they do seem to have done somewhat better than the Celts, who weren't even there at the time. So over to the man who is being called in Paris Le Big Mac, Conor McStay, over to you.